Welcome back, it's Nine, and today I have another video for you guys. We are going to be talking about Returnal, and we're going to be talking about Ghost of Tsushima. Some pretty big news items there regarding those two games. Now, before we get into that, if you haven't subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. Now, let's get started with Returnal and this Housemark tweet that has gone out. And they say, Returnal has finally gone gold. A huge thanks to everyone on the team at Housemark, PlayStation Studios, and all the other teams involved. We can't wait to have this out soon, and for every player out there to experience the planet of Atropos. All right, so this game is coming out April 30th. You know it's finally gone gold. We kind of know that it's going to come out for sure then. I mean, Cyberpunk is the anomaly that did end up going back on, going gold and not releasing, which I think it might have been the only game to ever do that. So, yeah, I don't think that's going to happen with Housemark's game. I am looking forward to this. You know, at first, it's hard to say how I feel about it because, well, I haven't played the game yet, of course. And on top of that, the price tag can be a bit of a turnoff for some people, given that this doesn't look like what you would expect of a AAA experience, and therefore the price tag seems like it should be that of a little bit lower, at least from what I've seen people say on the internet. Now, the way I feel is if this game is incredible, right? If it's a really good game with a lot of content, I think the price tag will be justified, but unfortunately, I feel like people might pass on this at first because the price tag is, it's like a full-priced game, right? Now, obviously, you find value in different things based on how you feel about it. So somebody might love this game and say, hey, this is worth $100, you know? And there might be others who would say they'd only pay $15 to $20 for it. Overall, for me, I'm going to buy this day one. I want to support PlayStation Studios, and I do want to support a developer like this. I feel like they've put a lot of effort forward. I feel like, you know, they really are trying to create the best game they have ever created, and it looks interesting and it looks fun. So I do want to give it a chance, and I do want to give it a fair shot. Now, when I do review it, I'm going to be critical of it like I would be critical of any other game. So, you know, I'm not going to just let anything pass because it is a full price game. So I expect that full price experience. So, you know, it goes hand in hand. Now, I am looking forward to it. I am going to play it. We're actually going to stream it as well over on my Twitch channel. That'll be in the description. And I'll put out a post whenever we end up doing that, the day it does come out. And I will do a formal review as well for this game for those of you who are on the fence about it and care about what I have to say. So that'll be there for you guys as well. And I'm also thinking about doing an additional video just of my experience mashed up, well edited, sharing it with you guys and seeing how that goes. Overall, I'm really excited for this. We'll check it out. We'll see what it's all about. And yeah, so on to our next topic. And this is all about Ghost of Tsushima. A lot of crazy stuff happening with this game right now, and it comes from PlayStation Blog. So this is titled The Ghost of Tsushima Movie is in the Works. Sucker Punch Productions provides first details on the Sony Pictures film being directed by Chad Stahelski. So this is a pretty big deal, guys. I can't believe that this IP has blown up this much. Like, I mean, I can believe it because it's so incredible, but I also can't believe it because it seems like it happened so fast. So I'm just going to read certain key points out of this post. I'm not going to read the entire thing, but it will be in the description for those of you who want to read the entire thing. It says a Ghost of Tsushima movie is in the works. The idea of translating our game into a new medium is exciting, and we're intrigued by the possibilities. To think that we could sit in the theater someday watching Jin Sakai up on the big screen is amazing. We'd all relive his tense transformation in the ghost from a whole new vantage point. So he says, we are happy to partner with Sony Pictures to make this happen, and Jin is in very good hands with the film's director. Chad Stahelski created something special with John Wick. His vision for what could be backed up by years of experience combined to create some of the finest action scenes ever created. I do think that this is a great director for this type of project. I can't wait to see what it's like. I love John Wick. Great film. Also, I'm happy to say we've sold more than 6.5 million copies of Ghost of Tsushima now, and that roughly half of those people have made it all the way through the game. Guys, these are incredible numbers. You know, for a studio that put out, you know, a game that kind of, you know, didn't get the greatest response, prior to Ghost of Tsushima with Second Son to now putting out Ghost of Tsushima, selling well. People are completing the game. You know, now they got a film coming out. There's a lot of great stuff happening here. And they were appointed ambassador for the real island of Tsushima. So there is so much going on with Sucker Punch right now. They're doing a lot of great work, and it's nice to see them able to, you know, find so much success with this new IP that I genuinely adored and loved. And I really enjoyed what they did with the game. It was so different in the sense of the way the environment was, the way they used the environment to guide you in the game. The combat was fantastic. There were so many good merits and to this game. I'm just so excited to see that they'll be doing more with this. And this obviously means we are going to see a Ghost of Tsushima 2. This has to happen. I don't think that we'll be surprised by that when it does get announced. But in terms of this movie, it'll be interesting to see what they do with it. I can't wait to see who they choose to play Jin Sakai and all the different characters in the game that will be in this movie. Now, I think it's interesting to see that Sony is now taking their IP and they're starting to make them into films or TV shows. Like, you got The Last of Us doing a TV show, you got this with the film, you have the Uncharted film, you have all sorts of stuff happening. And of course, Sony is big and Sony does films, so it only makes sense that they would do that. And I feel like, you know, they get this reputation for making games that are so cinematic and so narrative driven that they do actually fall into the category of films as well. They could like make films out of them. They are so well crafted as video games that they could also be put out as films too, and it wouldn't be weird. You know, it'd be probably a pretty seamless transition. So overall, this is exciting news for Sucker Punch. You know, this is exciting news for Housemarque. There's a lot going on with these guys and guys and girls over at the studio. I can't wait to see what they do, you know, going forward into the future. But that's all I have for you guys in today's video. I would love to hear from you guys. Do you plan on buying Returnal? How do you feel about Returnal in general with the full price tag? Are you still going to jump in? Are you going to wait for reviews to see how people feel? Are you going to wait for a sale? Let me know in the comments. How do you feel about this new Ghost of Tsushima movie in the works? Will you be watching this film? Or are you not interested? And about the sales, 6.5 million copies of Ghost of Tsushima sold now. That's crazy. And the over half of people who have completed the game. How does that make you feel as a PlayStation fan, Sucker Punch fan, you know, a fan of video games? Let me know in the comments. And as always, if you have not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch. Links will be in the description. And share this video with a friend. I will talk to you all on the next one. Take care.